On and recording, I think. Yes, it is. Right, short trip, folks, to good old Stirmister Newton. They're muzzling on it on the line. How pathetic. How very pathetic these people are. Black sky this morning, or a black cloud, I should say. The sky is blue, obviously. Looks like it might actually give us some moisture today, which is fine in my books. Temperature's still very warm. I'm just sat here in the basic minimum of clothes I would need, not to be offensive, shall we say? Because I think it's important not to overdress. Place there. There aren't any real passing places per se, but there are little areas of the road that are wider than others, so it comes in useful at times. Can you imagine? I used to run double-decker buses up here, well, single-deckers as well, which is nothing to do with the height, it's a width factor. It's the width. Easier for me to give way than for him. I'm in no rush. So I thought I'd have a little chit chat on the way down to the store. I'm only going down to buy some fruit, actually, and maybe some vegetable. I don't know about that. I don't know about the vegetable yet, but I certainly am needing to get some more fruit. I am out of grapefruit, and I love grapefruit. I now eat one every morning as a breakfast. A couple of pieces of toast with a segmented grapefruit. I know you can buy it in tins, but I don't like to buy tin stuff if I can avoid it. I don't want to pay for the tin. I don't want to pay for added whatever they put in with the fruit to preserve it. Well, I really don't want that, so I just as soon have a little bit more inconvenience and know that I'm eating actually something that's probably not been buggered about for too much. Although who knows whether the actual fruits have been GMO. We just don't know, but you've gotta eat. So at some point you're gonna be eating rubbish regardless, because that's a satanic system we live under. We don't have a lot of choice, unless you can buy verified GMO free seeds like I have. I bought quite a bit of GMO seed. Some of it worked, some of it didn't. I bought sprouts and swedes, I believe, and none of that worked. It didn't work out. Tomatoes, GMO free tomatoes, I got lots and lots of little tomatoes plants from seed, from that original seed I bought, so I know they're true, they're genetically pure in their type, and I'm hoping that I'll have a really good crop of them. I should give them away. I won't eat all of them. I will certainly eat quite a lot, because I do like tomatoes. Tomatoes. I like mine fried, actually, but hydrogenated cooking oil anymore. It'll be in cook stroke with a bloody muzzle on his face. It'll make me so angry. It won't be in hydrogenated crap oil, it'll be in butter. I'm just dosing that lay-by quick to get out of his way. Didn't need to, but let him get past. There's no way I can compete with a motorcycle for speed, or even most cars. In fact, I would say all cars. This thing isn't the speed freaks machine. 60 mile an hour is as fast as you're going to get out of this old girl thing. I did mean to call it girl, it's not a girl, it's a thing. It's just one of these silly little things that we always seem to get about mechanical things that have some emotional attachment, I suppose. Much like people call steam locomotive she, but they do here anyway. Japan calls them a he, I think. They're mainly the male gender to the Japanese. He or it is the preference, because they're not one or other, they are machines made by us to be used by us, but they're not. You can't bestow gender on something that has no gender. Although we still do, which is weird, ain't it? But that's it. Well, we're almost halfway to Stir Monster at the moment. I'm going to somewhere I don't normally go, and that's the fruit and veg shop. Just never remember it, never think about it. I always go to the supermarkets, but because the supermarkets have been very up and down with the supplies of grapefruit lately, I should go to the fresh fruit and veg shop, because they're sure to have them. If anybody's got them, they will have them. I did a quick live last night because I felt I needed to correct somebody on their channel. Not because I was doing it for any purpose other than just to correct them. I didn't do it for any self-aggrandizement or I better than you. Certainly that's not me, that's not the way I am. But when people are deceived, they preach truth, or so they think is the truth, but they're deceived on a very large level by something that's absolutely untrue. I think it behoves anybody that knows it's a lie to point that out to them. I mean, this guy is a good street preacher. But unfortunately, he still thinks he lives on a spinning ball. Now, he needs to be told that he doesn't live on a spinning ball, because that belief is going to taint his teachings. And thereby, they're not going to be good teachings, because he's mixing a little bit of leaven in with a loaf, as the Bible says. A little leaven ruins the whole, spoils the whole loaf. Well, that's true. That is so very, very true. That's exactly what it does. It absolutely does ruin the whole loaf. So, if you're going to be out there preaching and spending your time and doing what you can on the street, said you've got to get your story right. It's essential. Thank you. beer in Sturminster. I'll do a chit chat on the way back as well, probably. In fact, I would say that was almost a certainty, unless something very untoward happens to me in the interim. So, this is where I need to be going to the shop. For these idiots with their muzzles on. Sad, sad people. Are you going across or what? You are. It's alright. Come on, get past me. It's quite simple. Just get past me. So what you got to do? I've just got to go to the shop, so I'm going to shut this thing off for a minute.
Yeah, you can get past here, alright.
I hope that Gregor's don't want to come down here, because he's going to be out of luck if he does. Actually, I could park down there, couldn't I, go to Butcher's? That would make more sense, that would give him a bit more room. So I'll go down and park by the Butcher's. That's what I'm going to do. Oh, that's better too. I got room to pull in here. Alright, let's go and do this thing. I'll be back shortly, folks.
from Nathania.
Oi, oi, oi. Oi, yeah.
Right, I'm back. That was pretty quick, wasn't it? I'm sure you've got a lovely smile, lady. I could see her eyes crinkling up, so I knew she did smile. She's ruined her smile. Put a rag on her face. So anyway, that's neither here nor there. It's her choice. We gotta go around here. What a place this is to get round. It's an awkward little place, isn't it? Awkward little roads to get round. Right, I can get out because he's going. Ah, that wasn't bad. Nice, that shop I just passed on the right, that white shop, that's the one. The fruit and vegetable shop. It's all good. It's all good, people. Oh, give me a home where the buffaloes roam and the deer and the antelopes play. I beat you lights today. You didn't catch me this time. Oh, no. Oh, lordy. Oh, cantare. Oh, no wonder my happy heart sings. I'll stop actually trying to sing because it's annoying. It annoys me, I don't know about people that listen to it. So we're on our way back home again. It's going to be an exciting day. As soon as I get back and parked up, I've got to take the bin in. There's some excitement for you. Excitement. I'm gonna get out before you, tractor. I'm not waiting here for you to come down. That's a nice talk. I like our sections. I did have one once. Long time ago. Poor old chap, he didn't last long, but I think he enjoyed his last few months with us as we were a couple. He passed on, unfortunately. He was taken to the vets for his final trip. He had a lot wrong. But also, the girl, a lady that I was shacked up with at that time, she also passed on with a brain tumour, brain hemorrhage. 36 years old she was when she went. Pretty sad. I'm hoping she was saved. There is a life to come. There's two alternatives. There's either a life of peace, joy, love, or there's one of eternal regret and torment. For those that reject the truth, I mean, let's face it, the Almighty, forgiven as he is, if people are going to keep pushing him away, then what choice does he have? We've been given free choice to either accept or reject. Those that reject, I really feel sorry for them because they don't know what they're doing. A bit like the mask wearers, they just don't know what they're doing. They're believing all the pernicious lies that are spread all over about something that doesn't even exist. They still believe it, with all the evidence and truth to the contrary of what they think is reality. But they still go on and believe it. So very, very sad. But a lot of us who are who know better that realize we've been lied to about virtually everything, we're not 100% safe either, because if we still reject the Almighty, if we still believe everything earthly that's been false and bullshit, which most of it has, but we still reject the actual truth, although it's right in front of us, then we're not going to fare any better than those that are absolutely lost. That is what I need to remember from a personal standpoint. I'm not saying this to anybody else particularly, certainly not aimed at any individual, but from a personal standpoint, yes, I definitely need to keep that in mind, keep that uppermost in my mind. And people say, well, you know, it's just fairy tale. Well, it isn't, but even if it were fairy tales, as you like to term it, what is the harm in living a decent life where you're not engaged in things that aren't good for you, or certainly not good for other people that you come in contact with? I mean, what is the harm in keeping yourself on a moral compass which keeps you above base instincts? I don't see a problem with that. I see a danger with it for some people because they get on their moral high horse and look down upon others. I don't look down on anybody. I feel sorry for people that wear the muzzles. They annoy me, they get me angry. They piss me off because their capitulation to Satan is dragging everyone else down along with them. That is my only gripe. But as individuals, I know that when you actually talk to these people, even with their muzzles on, you can understand them, and I'm not being funny, you've got a job to understand them, because they sound like they're in some war movie in an aircraft, like, you know, this is Red Leader 1, here is Red Leader 2, Red Leader 3, do you hear me, over? Roger, and all that stuff. You know, when people talk like that, it's ridiculous. They don't realise how ridiculous they are. But I don't look down on them as being less than me. I often say, yeah, they're not human, but they are, obviously. The trouble is, they are people that look down on others, especially the so-called Christian ones, that have this high moral standpoint. They are in danger of doing they're doing exactly the same thing on an obverse level to the people they look down on. They're prideful. They are placing themselves above and beyond. And pride is the thing that brought Satan low. That is the thing, the pride, that it could be better than its creator. No, sorry, you are never going to be better than your creator, ever. Are you coming through, or what are you going to do? Or are you going in there? You can never be better than your own creator. Sad situation to find yourself in. I'm almost back home now, would you believe it? Almost, but not quite. I would love changing the subject completely, completely off culture, but that's what the kind of thing I do. I would love for somebody somewhere who knows where there's a stand of an untreated, chemical-free Japanese knotweed to send me a room. That's what I most want right now, because it's a very highly thought of plant in its native country, Japan, China, where it's used medicinally. And I think that's the reason there's such a big downer on it. Not because it does that much damage, I don't believe it does. Alright, it's very invasive. A lot of things are invasive, but they don't show this paranoid, this psychotic reaction to other things. And there's lots of worse things out there plant-wise than Japanese knotweed. No, I think it's that the hatred is because the managed to get away from it. That's good. Those two throws are pretty tight turning. Now this is my parking place anyway, as you know. It's got so many good things medicinally. I think this is why it's demonized. And there's one property that I want it for specifically. That's why I asked. If anybody has any, especially in the UK, that ever looks at this channel, you know, I don't want stuff that's been poisoned already, that's dead. If you can find a piece and dig up a little bit of root, throw it in a bag, I'll pay you for the postage and your inconvenience. But I would love some. Japanese knotweed. Okay, folks, I've just about reached my destinazione. That's it. Now we're parked beautifully, as always. Engine off. I should have kept my... I got my little spy camera with me and I never turned it on. So that was a waste of time putting that in my pocket, wasn't it? Never mind. Alright, I'm going to disconnect the dash cam and I'm going to take all this inside and then upload it on my YouTube channel. Thanks, folks. Out you come, camera.